Hello Chennai Online viewers. Today we are at Gokhale Shastri Institute. Today we have here Mr. Suresh Padmanabhan. He has been having this I Love Money workshops for past 10 years. It has been helping lots of people to realize the effectiveness of money and how importantly and effectively do we use it in our life. So let's go on to him to hear what he says about it. Hello sir.
Yeah, hi.
So for the past 10 years, you have been having this I Love Money workshop. So how and when did you decide that this is what you were going to talk to people about?
It's a very interesting story. In fact, Chennai gave birth to money workshop. It was around 1999. It's almost 11 years since I've been running the money workshop worldwide. And it started out here in Chennai. So it's almost 11 years and we have been doing phenomenally well over all these years. And Money Workshop has been a very impactful program in the sense that it has been an original workshop, and right across wherever I come and connect to people, they see the empowerment of the program in its fullest level, because hardly we have any program on money. You know, there are hundreds and thousands of programs on self-development, public speaking, so many things, you know, but money, which is the most vital area of our life, we hardly pay attention to it. And that was a single purpose where we have this extraordinary creation of the Money Workshop, where actually the magic and mystery starts unfolding in front of whoever is participating.
So according to you, what is the role do you think that money plays in a man's life? Other than the basic necessity, what other powerful role does it play?
Okay. In fact, we say that right from the day you are born to the moment you die and even beyond, money is so vital. In fact, it runs every spectrum of life. One can even be a housewife or a student or somebody who is retired, but money will play a critical role till their very end. It somehow emphasizes that money is very vital. Somewhere in the book I Love Money, which is today a bestseller, which I had authored about 5-6 years back, now translated into 12 languages, there's a very vital element which emphasizes the aspect of money, which says that money is as vital as the air which we breathe, or the baby has milk. It's as vital as that. Somewhere we need to understand that money is going to be a part and parcel of life. So we need to realize that as it is going to be a part and parcel of life, let us give the right emphasis to it. When I say that, I mean to say that it should not be like money minded and you run after money like crazy. That's not the purpose. The purpose is to understand money in its holistic dimension, so that it actually starts flowering into our life. It becomes like a friend to us, and our life is celebrative in its all aspect. That is the purpose of money, and it's very vital. I mean, look at it, that somebody has come out of college and he or she wants a job. What do they aim for? They would aim for a job which they deserve, where the salary would be good enough. Or it could be somebody who just started on a career and they want to keep going ahead. They would look at how much quantum jumps they want to do in terms of money. So in fact, everything that we do around is measured in terms of money. So money is one vital measurement that we have. So it would run right across life. And that's the beauty of the money.
Yes, sir. So do you think everyone in this world actually realize the importance of money?
Deep down, yes, everybody knows that money is important. But here we would like to put it in this way, that many people are not consciously aware of it. Money is a part of life. We take it for granted and we keep moving across. And we do what is called as trial and error. We keep learning by trial and error. And this is one of the aspects of life. Very few actually give attention to money. I'm a Tamilian, so I know that my father and mother, right from my childhood, told me about studying is very important than money. So my consciousness was all about studying. So generally, if you see a South Indian family, the emphasis is more on studying better, earning a gold medal and being outstanding, etc. Whereas I fortunately stayed in Pune, where I had some of the best Marwadis, Gujaratis and other kind of communities, where the emphasis is on start looking into the area of money as early as childhood itself. So, as South Indians, we pay less attention to money. Marwadis and Gujaratis, I would per se, pay a great deal of attention. But the whole dimension is that, can I pay attention to money in a conscious manner so that it is also a vital part of life? At the same time, when I start paying attention to money, it starts becoming better in my life. It starts growing in my life. And that is the single purpose of money workshop. Start paying vital attention to money. I was in Moscow actually for a book signing event, and there emphasizes what really happened. As I was in a book signing event, a lady came charging at me, and she said that you're speaking about evil. I was real stunned, and she was speaking in Russian, and I had a Russian translator. I said, "No, ma'am, I'm speaking about money." She said, "No, no, you're speaking about evil. Don't you realize that somewhere I had read and I have a belief system which says that money is a source of all evil. So you're speaking about evil." I was real stunned, and I was dazed. Couple of minutes, I gathered my composure and I told her that, "Ma'am, actually, do you think that money is evil?" And she said, "Yes, very emphatically. Money is a source of all evil." I said, "Fine, ma'am, I wouldn't like to argue with you on this count. So why don't you do me a favor? Or rather, why don't you do yourself a favor?" She said, "Yeah, what?" "Give me all your evil, I'll accept it, and you can be rid of it." Then she realized that money is vital, and she vanished before I could take a second glance at her. This shows that many communities, many religions, many countries where I have been traveling, money is not directly looked at. Sometimes I would feel that we are hypocrites. We all need money, money is vital, but we don't pay attention to it, or we criticize it, we condemn it. It is time that we look at money as one of the important vital aspects of life and take on from there. That will be a nice way, right?
Okay, sir. So this I Love Money workshop is for people of all age groups, right? So what are the aspects that you cover under this workshop?
Infinitely, I'll tell you the age groups. We have had children as young as 7 and 8 coming to the money workshop, attending with their families. We encourage family participation because we feel vital that if the family is there, it has to be united. If the wife is running in one direction, the husband is running in one direction, sum total is they come to zero level. So somewhere, understanding money is very vital. That's why we encourage children to participate along with family. In fact, it'll be very shocking to understand that whatever our learnings of money have been very at a subconscious level. And it wouldn't be wrong to say that we have had an imprint of money as much as minus 9 months onwards. So it is so deep and so profound. That's why that is one age group where we would like the family to participate. And the maximum participation we have had of a couple of people who are even above 80. So simply it runs across spectrum of life. And somewhere we all need to realize that what happens in the money workshop is an absolute experience. Today, you're in an online portal, so you know that you can go to Google and just type out money. You'll have a billion zillion sites coming across, zillions. In fact, there is a very big danger, which we call it as excessive information syndrome. There is too much of information floating around. So how does a participation in a workshop help, or how would money workshop actually help? Money workshop is a two-day, very intensive aspect to look at money from a very, very close perspective. The beauty of the money workshop is that you have got 2 days, and tell me the last time when you actually looked into money, giving hours attention also to it. We don't. We take it for granted and run across life. Very hardly we ponder. We ponder about money when we lose it, which is not a healthy way anyway. If we start pondering it before, we might not even lose it. So it is a two-day amazing, the setting is very beautiful in a star hotel, everything is taken care of, so all you need to do is pay attention to money. And the vital areas we cover are the entire gamut of money, right from the instructions manual of money. I would like to put it as the instructions manual of money, which is very important. See, you go to a store to buy a mobile phone, or you go to a store to buy a television, you get an instructions manual along with it. But tell me, do you have the instructions manual of money? You don't. So what happens is that the complete instructions manual of money starts unfolding in a very participative, in a very experiential manner. The beauty is the experience. That is why if you look at the Indian Shastras, they always told the vital need of participating in a physical presence. In a physical presence, many dimensions change. So we would look at money from many aspects. First is unfolding the instructions manual of money. Out of which the major component is that it is not that we don't know about money. We all know a lot about money. But what do we know about money is many belief systems which we have, which we are not sure which of it is actually in the right direction, which of it is not in the right direction. So here you actually come to know what will take me ahead in life. What is the right component of money? What is the truth of money? And how, if I can use it wisely. So the first whole aspect deals about the belief systems. Second whole aspect deals about how the script of money comes into life. Like I told you, there's a South Indian script, there's a Marwadi script, there is a Jew script, or there could be an American script, there could be an Indian script. How does it happen into our life? And how do we function thereof? Then the third vital aspect of money is the physical money. How do we handle it? How do we invest it? How do we utilize it wisely? Then there are many other aspects to it. Like for example, when I ask the people a very vital question, okay, I've been handling money for a long time. Tell me, by closing your eyes, can you see the picture of the 100 rupee note that you have been handling? Many people are dumbfounded. They can't even see money clearly. So somewhere we come to the realization that we have been handling it very blindly. So the objective of money is to handle it with consciousness. So there will be a huge aspect on the consciousness of money, which will be very, very amazing. Then the most amazing part of money workshop is we put people under various situations. Because only in a situation will you actually learn. Imagine a person is working for a long number of years, he has taken life for granted, and one day the boss says that you are out of the job. Suddenly he is put into a situation where a lot of things internalizing will unfold. Like that, we put people under various situations so that whatever aspects they have about money will surface. And then we tell them which of it is false and which of it is right. So that would be a whole gamut of it. Then we talk about what is called the money matrix. This is one of the most fantastic discoveries I could make, where we have many components of money. We have, like, you know, we have an EMI, which many people, especially from IT, are not sure how much component should be an EMI, and they are recklessly spending money. And we have an earnings, we have a savings, we have a spending, we have an investing, and we have debts. These are the large components of money. So that is a one-hour amazing discovery where actually your whole life falls into a perspective. The money matrix is a single thing which they can attend. It's going to take them very, very way ahead. So like that, there are many, many aspects to money that will unfold, including behavior. Today what I see is that a lot of people are very happy when they do a shopping. And so we are trying to fill a vacuum with something material, which is not a very healthy trend. So if shopping is done wisely, it's great. But if I am feeling empty inside and I do a shopping, temporarily I might feel great. So there are many aspects to money which comes in, and other vital aspects will be decision making. Many people tell me that I'm not able to take a wise decision on money. How do I do it? And these are very vital components which unfortunately school or college doesn't teach. So come to the money workshop to experience it.
So that's quite a lot of aspects that you're facing on. So what are the strategies that you use to cover this, what, to fulfill these aims that you're trying for?
See, a workshop is different than a seminar. A seminar is a one-way process, where in a workshop it is absolutely participative. So the minute the people stepped in fact, the greatest aspect of money workshop is, even when they enroll, they think that, okay, I would like to do a money workshop. From that time, as itself, transformation starts happening in some levels into their life. Because simply now they are paying attention to money in the conscious spectrum. So that is the first important aspect is, the minute you commit to something, your consciousness travels in that direction. And strategically, all we tell people is that, you just come with an empty state of mind. And just give us two vital days of your life. Whatever magic has to happen, we will ensure it happens. And fortunately, I've had the good privilege of meeting hundreds of thousands of people. I've had addressed seminars as large as 50,000 people at one shot. So that's the beauty of the money workshop, is unfoldment. Though in the money workshop, we have about 40-50 participants, where it's a small group, but like to impact them, where they will start unraveling their own life. So the first aspect is a small group. Second aspect is that when they immediately come in, they start realizing strategically where they are. Like today, I need to know where am I to know where I should be going. So they realize two points, that I am here, I need to go there. And then they would get various vehicles to go. Like for example, if I am in Chennai, I need to go to Bombay. I know one place is Chennai and I know the destination is Bombay. So I need to go there. I can go by various methods. So we teach them various vehicles to reach there, various techniques, various tools. So techniques and tools will form a major spectrum of the money workshop. And like I said, is the blueprint of money workshop unfolding in the instructions manual, which will be done by role plays, which will be done through games, it will be done through exercises, which will be done through a lot of introspection, be done through meditation, mudras, mantras, run the spectrum right across. And some many phenomena which they would not even have heard of.
So that sounds like more than a talkative area, it'll be more of fun attending it and learning it at the same time.
100%.
Yeah. So in your aims that you have provided according to the workshop, you have made a statement saying that destroy hard work forever. How do you make it happen? Because it's a natural phenomenon that it is not possible to get anything without hard work. How did you make the statement, and how will you make it work out?
Somewhere there is a very, very wrong connotation with money. If you look at the whole nature, one of the principles of nature is principle of harmony. And if we as human beings need to learn, we need to learn from nature itself. In the whole of the cosmos, in the whole of the existence, there are zillions and zillions of plants, animals and creatures, out of which human being is also one of them. But if you look with open eyed across the universe, one thing for sure you'll find. The thing is that except human beings who struggle and who do so-called hard work, none of the other creatures struggle. They're just easy flowing. If you see an eagle flying thousands of feet above the ground, it's flying blissfully. There is no struggle. If you see a cheetah running at 120 kilometers per hour, there's no struggle. Human beings inherently struggle. And I would feel it is the biggest privilege or a gift for a human being to discover the purpose for which they are born. Many of them discover in the money workshop. Why am I struggling with life? Struggle is hard work. I would put it as struggle is hard work. And hard work is the biggest myth associated with money. In languaging I can use, okay, I do hard work. But hard work as a languaging and hard work within are two dimensionally different things. If I'm struggling with work, if I'm getting up at Monday morning and I need to go to work and I have no energy to move across, isn't it a curse on us? It is. Somewhere we feel that the hard work forever should be destroyed. When we say destroy hard work means what? We say that start understanding the harmony of existence, start understanding the harmony of yourself, start understanding the harmony for which you're doing a job, work or a business. When all this tuning starts happening, it's beautiful. And one of the things for sure happens in the money workshop is that many people actually start dropping hard work. And some of them actually come into ease of work, which is the most fantastic phenomenon of life.